Hello, hello. Welcome. It is 7:30 and hi Roxy, hi Bella. Good evening. Hello Elaine, good to have you. Shalika. Tonight is restore and release for half an hour. Basically means self-massage in the best way possible. Kind of. Hi, Shalika. And then half an hour of guided meditation. So that is the plan for tonight. Please put in the comments if you, I love it, Elaine, all ready to relax. Good. If you have an area that you would like to address tonight. Hi, Sandy. We already have a request tonight for shoulders. So definitely gonna address a little bit of shoulder work. It seems like a recurring theme. Hi, Amy Mayerson. Patty, good to have you guys. Yay. So yes, and Paris too. Welcome, welcome. So tonight, if you have anything that you are, that's hurting, that you feel like you need to address, please feel free to type it in the comments. I will try and address that area. I definitely got shoulders. If there's anything else, let me know. And we'll get started in like 30 seconds. I hope you all are doing well. Happy Tuesday. End of a Tuesday, right? Today was a weird day. Hi, Marina. Very weird day. Just all over the place, but lots accomplished. Good evening, Neha. Good to have you. Yay. Yeah, it's all over the place. Good evening, Lisa. I love it. You guys are so awesome. Okay, so we're going to get started. Nobody's really said anything. I'm serious when I say please let me know if there's something bugging you. It was super weird, honey, right? My husband's watching this too. He should be down here. He just commented.
Oh my gosh.
My daughter's here as well. So tonight, lacrosse balls or tennis balls, softballs, whatever you got, you can use, okay? Foam roller also works. This one's a mean one. Any foam roller will do. You're welcome, Sandy. Okay, you guys ready? Other than your shoulders, anything else?
Knees.
Yes. Knees. Okay, so we're gonna do a knee on facing down on the floor to address that area in particular. So I'm gonna take just one. Okay. Now, if this doesn't feel comfortable to you and you don't have the ball, you can certainly use the foam roller instead. Right? What you're gonna do is you're gonna find the top of your kneecap and you're gonna pull back and place the ball there. You're gonna hold that ball there, okay? And then you're gonna pretty much come into a plank position with the ball right at the top of that patella or the kneecap, okay? And with your leg 90 degree bent, just dig in. Find a spot, you're definitely gonna find it. Whether you're on top of the foam roller or the ball, either way, you don't have to pull back because you can just press down and the skin will push back when you press downward on the foam roller. But same idea, little forward and back, little side to side. Good.
Get your leg 90, the leg that's on. Mm-hmm. So 90 degrees.
With your foot to the ceiling. Oh. There you go. Good. You can all be all the way down in plank position. Nice. Hi, Sean, Darlene. So, Lorena, nice to see you guys here. We're with the whole crew. Take and bend and straighten that leg now. Oh, yes. Hi, Ashley. finding it?
She's pretty quiet over there, so I don't know. Just asking.
All right, keep going. Now, with your leg fully extended, toes down on the floor, if you've got enough, you can just stay there. If you need more, you can stack the other leg. Okay, and then we're gonna do the same thing, forward and back. If it's plenty for you and you're like, no, just keep the other leg unstacked, okay? That's okay, you don't have to. You can continue, and you can even, if your shoulders are feeling a little bit weary, go ahead and lay your torso on the floor. You don't have to stay in a plank position. Good, yeah. Hi, Amy, good to have you. A little side to side. Now it's the ball almost wants to slip out from underneath. So just go to find what works, basically. Good. Oh man, I didn't know I needed this one. Good. Little circles. Pushing through your toes, both directions. And then a nice melt. So you can let your whole body drop to the mat, let your leg go down, relax your foot, try and get the top of your foot to go as relaxed as possible. Good. Nice. Three, two, and one. Go ahead and roll off. Foam roller or not. And we're gonna get the other side. So same deal, opposite side, okay? You're gonna take and pull the skin back if you have the ball. Okay, normally we have I will use a block at the club, but I don't have any blocks. Or, like I said, foam roller works too. Okay, come down into that plank position, holding that ball in place. Get on top of it, good. Leg is bent 90 degrees. I don't know if you can see that behind me. Good. And then you're just pushing through, forward and back. Dig in, find it, get it. Good. And a little side to side. Awesome. Keep going. Just because I'm stopping, don't stop. Hi, Rob. Good to have you. Or maybe it's Sarah. Good. Dig in. Excellent. Now take that leg, bend and extend. Drop it and lift it. Good. So the reason why we do this is manifold, and again, we'll apologize to those who have heard this same thing over and over again, but it's crazy important that those who are new understand the purpose behind it, because if you don't know the why of something, you probably won't keep doing it, right? Number one, of course, it's good for you. Number two, flexibility, mobility. Number three, longevity, therefore, in your working out. And then increases your metabolism, and also endorphins. Lots of reasons, okay? Go ahead and stack that other leg. Remember, it is totally optional. If it's too much, don't do it. You can also drop your torso to the floor. Good. Through those toes, pushing forward and back, little side to side. Takes a little bit of core to stay on top of that ball. Good. So if you're wondering, if this is the first time, kind of hurts. Yeah, just a little, right, Lisa? If you're wondering, like, if this is your first time, how in the heck is this gonna increase my metabolism? Well, if your muscles aren't firing properly because you're stuck, you're not gonna metabolize properly. Metabolism is what happens when your muscles fire and your energy is used. So if you're not 100%, you're not going to burn at 100%, right? Good. Okay. Now's the time to relax that leg. Let the whole body come down to the floor. Relax the foot as much as you can, top of the foot. Nice and rested. And continue to breathe. 3, 2, and 1. Good job. Go ahead and roll off. Now, I still haven't seen any commentary on any other areas, so I'm going to continue with the knees and simultaneously address the calves. Those of you that took class with me today, I think you'll really appreciate that. We did some calf work, so you might be tight in that region. So we've done this before. Hi, Art. Good to have you. So we're going to take the, I know, this is a repeat performance because, you know, hey, you find something that works, you keep doing it, right? So back behind on the outside of that knee. Now, if you're with a foam roller, I'm going to show you that option in just a second. Okay? You're going to just lean forward into it. Good? If this is not enough for you, go ahead and really dig in. Yeah? Good. Okay? Keep going with that. You're just rocking back and forth, really digging in to the back of the knee, all those all that tissue back there, and the calf as well. If you've got the foam roller, you're gonna stack, and it doesn't feel good, in case you were wondering. None of this typically feels good, but when you're done, what it produces, the short amount of pain that you have to go through, discomfort, and really it's kind of a hurt so good type of pain, that short amount of pain on the other side, you feel so much better. How true in life, right? Good. Oh, he's yucky back there. Yep. Oh my gosh. Ooh. Yeah, I know I keep repeating the same thing over and over again, but for those of you that keep coming back for more. But if you don't address these issues, you will pay for them later. And so that's another reason why we do this. Hi, Christine. Good to have you. So now that you've done the outside, you've got to get the inside. Okay? So inside of that knee. It's almost to the point where it wants to pop out from underneath. Okay, but you're holding it in place, whether you're here or a lot deeper, if you're here or on that foam roller. Either way, however you slice it, you're gonna feel it, right? Oh, man. Other leg, guys. Outside of that leg. Hug it nice and tight. Using that foam roller. Both sides. And lean in. Lean in. Get it. Find it. Oh. I found it. I found it, guys. Good. Nice job. Yeah. Nobody wants to be in pain, right? Everyone wants that quick fix, get me out of it. I don't want it. But sometimes the pain is a good thing. It tells you something's off. If we didn't have it, we'd be in a whole heap of trouble, right? Whole heap of trouble. Good.
good. We're gonna move to the inside now. Hi, Renee. Welcome. Keep leaning in. Excellent. And oftentimes, I know you've heard me say this before, but where you're actually feeling the pain isn't often the actual source of the pain. So if I could, Joyelle, what? Welcome. Good to have you, my friend. So if you are experiencing pain, like shooting down the leg, or say for instance, plantar fasciitis, that plantar fasciitis is actually tightness in the calf. Most of you are getting familiar, especially if you're endurance athlete and you understand that principle. But if you think about it, all these muscles right here, if they're tight, they're pulling on your foot muscles and therefore creating plantar fasciitis. So addressing the entire area is a good idea. Okay, let's get to the shoulders, yes? All right, you can have your ball, or if you've got the foam roller, you're gonna stay on the floor, but we're gonna move to the wall. It's okay. All right, let's move to the wall. If you're on the foam roller, you're going to do the same exact movement patterns on the floor, okay? We're going to get nice and high, the top of the shoulders, okay? As I run into furniture, I've been doing that all day today. I want enough pressure where you have to put your feet out so you can dig in, okay? So once you find it, you're really almost the ball. My child is freaking out. The ball's almost gonna pop out from underneath your shoulder, okay? And you're just gonna take and roll up and down. Okay? Once again, I'm gonna show you exactly. You're probably gonna find it, no problem. But nice and high, right up top, okay? Good. Just dig in, it's like a meal. Nice and hearty, right? Good, keep going. Nice job. Hi, Janice. Okay, right there. If you're on that foam roller, you really have to lift your hips to dig in. And it's not as pointed, of course, but like I said, a tennis ball, you don't have to have a lacrosse ball. I just like these because they get into the fibers a little bit better. Or if you have like a trigger point ball, these are mean but great as well. Good. And then do a little side to side. And then when you found that spot that's really singing to you, that's telling you, you're gonna stay on that spot with the ball or the foam roller, and we're gonna add some arm movement, okay? Now, I have a TV in my way, so hopefully you guys don't. You can move to where there's open space. But from here, you're going to take and snow angel your arm all the way up and down. If you're not feeling it enough, walk a little more further out away from your body, and you're gonna have a little more intensity that way. Good. Up and down. Nice. Good. And then down and up, backstroke style. All the way down and up. We carry a lot of tension in shoulders, right? Whether you know it or not. Good. Nice. And then take that hand on the shoulder, elbow out in big circles. Big circles.
to do is actually take your head and neck the opposite direction. Do some circles and then reverse the circle. Good. And then take your head and go the opposite direction and circle the opposite direction as well. Good. And circle again, opposite direction. Nice. Everything's connected. You may feel it differently from here to here, right? Good. Little shrug of the shoulders up and down. Oh, right? Nice. Three, two, and one. Beautiful. Then walk it back. If you're on that foam roller, we're just going to switch and go a little bit more to the other side. So, slightly lean in if you're using that butt piece. So remember, like I said, nice and high, and the further out your feet are, the more you're gonna feel it.
Sore hamstrings? Maybe, yeah. Let's do it right after this. Good. Are you sore from Monday? Yesterday and today? Oh my goodness, yeah. Lots of sore from yesterday. Good. Okay, we're going to do those arm movements. Thanks for asking, Lisa. It never hurts to ask.
Right? I'm good here.
She's I'm good. All right. We have
say hello to your plants
every week, right? That we do this. Snow angels along the wall. It was hello to the TV, and now it's hello to the good. Try and relax your shoulders out of your ears. Yeah, I know. This one's fun.
Hi. Against the wall for strengthening yesterday,
That might be why.
Beach. Yeah, and you did downward dog kind of push-ups.
Oh, yeah.
And I hadn't either of those, so my shoulder was shot. Oh,
good. Okay, backstroke. Good. Remember, if it starts to get comfortable, you might need to push yourself, meaning you might need a little more intensity by walking your feet out just a bit more. Hi, Sarah. Hi, Denise. Thanks for popping in. Okay, let's hand on the shoulder, big circles. Good, other direction. Take our head and neck opposite direction of the arm that's moving and circle back. Good. And circle back opposite again. Good. And now we're going to face the same side and change the direction of the circle again. Ah! And back around. Time. Good. Oh, awesome. Come back center and get any kind of movement you feel like you need left in that mix. Anything that you really felt like was addressing your shoulders. Good. So good.
get those hamstrings really quick before we move on to our guided meditation. So if you have a foam roller, you have a seat, only one leg on top, okay? Right at the base of where your bum and leg meet, okay? So I'm looking for, boom, right there. Now if you have the ball, same idea, okay? Right there, the lip, right? You got the foam roller, it covers a little more ground. The opposite leg is gonna be bent, you're gonna lean into it, your foot is facing the ceiling, and then you're just going to roll back and forth. Ball or foam roller, either way. Now, just keep in mind, there's a ton of connective tissue in this region. So if especially you have the ball, there will be a little bit of jumpiness as we move laterally, okay? Side to side. Oh my gosh. Lisa, thank you. Right? Take the front foot and fully bend and flex and point. Ooh. Oh my gosh. Oh yeah. Good. All right. Before we finish the side, you to lean forward into it, hug your knee, try and relax as much as you can. You can take your foot and do whatever feels best. Sometimes I like letting it fall to the side. Good. And 3, 2. To the ceiling. I should back up a little so you can see a little better. All right. Woo. Right away, right? Lean into it. A little forward and back. Good. Mostly moving the torso and then a little side to side. So I know I've said this next bit before, but your fascia is incredibly important, and a lot of people think, oh, it's my muscles. Yes, of course, your muscles are sore, but what prevents you from moving appropriately is when your fascia gets matted, what they call matted. And your fascia is actually the layer that is on top of your muscles. It is not your muscles. So the knot that you get, sometimes you can, it's very rare, but most of the time the crunchy is your fascia. It's all messed up and knotted up. So what you're doing right now is you're getting rid of the knots, the crystals that have formed in your tissue. Of course, Tammy. Hurts so good, right? Okay, we're gonna point and flex. Point and flex right here. Boom and boom. Point and pull back. Vegetarian, but if you have meat and there's that thin layer of white webbing, that's fascia, and that's what you're addressing right now. Good. Little side to side. Tick tock. Oh my gosh. Good. Nice. And then lean forward, hug that knee, and relax into it.
like you're melting over top. Good. Oh, 3, 2. Goes by way too fast, you guys, right? It is already 8 o'clock. It's time to move on to our guided meditation. So I ask that you guys grab whatever you need to feel comfortable laying down. So if you actually need to hop on the couch or your bed or somewhere else where you feel like this is gonna help me relax, do it. Obviously, this is where I'm gonna be, and I'm gonna be chatting you guys up. We are gonna go on a journey today. I'm good, honey.
Well, thank you, though.
Yes, she brought me my favorite blanket. It's so soft. Blankets, pillows, relaxation, right? We all need it. Even though we're cooped up, it can be stressful, and we can not even realize it, and it builds up. And so tonight, I want you guys to feel like that there is a sense of release from that. Hi, Jessica. Oh, I miss your face. All right, you guys. So before we get started on the journey, tonight is gonna be about gratitude and joy and how we unlock potential, okay? First thought as we begin. Gratitude unlocks the fullness of life. It turns what we have into enough and more, right? Are you grateful? Because when you don't have that attitude of gratitude, it can just eat away at you, and it just brings the entire environment down, right? And you can feel it. You can feel the difference when you have a heart of gratitude and when you don't. Thank you, Janice. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful evening. If you can come next time and stay for the guided meditation, please do. Okay. Turn the music down. Okay. All right, so I'm going to repeat that thought. As I'm repeating it, I want you guys to get into a laying down position, get comfortable, pillows under the head, and we're gonna get into a breathing pattern that's going to help you relax just a little bit more. All right, again, that thought, gratitude unlocks the fullness of life. It turns what we have into enough and then some and more. Right? Good. Okay. Now, I want you to imagine we're going to be traveling up the body and trying to relax each part from our toes all the way up to our head. Okay? But before we begin that, I want you guys to place one hand on your diaphragm or belly, one hand on the heart. We're gonna breathe deeply in through the nose, filling full and raising the hand on the belly higher than the hand on the heart. Okay, breathe in deep, deep, deep. And exhale all that air out. Let it all out, squeezing with your core to get every last bit out. Good, and again. Keep breathing. This particular breathing technique actually assists in bringing that fight or flight mentality, that fight or flight response, and it takes it and it does the opposite. It calms you down, it relieves the stress, it turns it off, it helps you sleep better at night if you have insomnia. This 10 times before you go to bed is going to help you, I promise. Good. Keep breathing in through the nose
you to imagine a heavy roller. It's not going to hurt you, but I want you to imagine the weight of this heavy roller. It's not a foam roller, it's heavy. It's got some oomph to it, okay? That roller is gonna be placed on your feet, and it's slowly gonna roll up your body, okay? Starting with the feet, feel the weight of it, imagine it on top of your feet right now. Feel your body pressing into the floor, feel those feet pressing down, good. And slowly rolling up to your ankles. Feel that weight move up your shins, pressing your calves into the floor. It doesn't hurt in any way, shape, or form, it's just weighted relaxation. Moving up toward your knees. Feel the backs of your knees press into the floor. Good. All the way up past your kneecaps and onto your quads. Pressing down, rolling slowly like molasses. To the hips. Feel that weight, feel that relaxation as your body just feels pressed down into the floor. Good. Roll all the way up past your belly button. To your chest. As well. Good. And now it's like if you've ever gotten a facial, that heavy hot towel falling on your face, that weight, relaxation. Good. Continue to breathe. Good. Now in a place of pure relaxation, where you feel heavy yet light at the same time, I want you guys to think about a place. It's a magical place. It's the kind where fairies live. And you've entered the start of the forest, and you peek in, and you can see the sun shining through the trees in rays, landing on the flowers that dot the forest floor below. Majestic pine trees shoot straight up from the earth. There's moss on the ground, there's rocks and beautiful foliage everywhere you look, ferns. You can hear the wildlife, the birds chirping. You can hear the creek babbling to your left, and you're drawn in. There's no well-worn path in this forest, so you have to watch where you're stepping. The ground underneath your feet is soft. It's almost like walking on pillows. And you feel a sense of excitement and wonder. destination is a very, very special place. You're headed for the Tree of Wisdom. Is in a little bit of an open field, but you have to find it, you have to get to it. It's calling to you, and you're on your way. Enjoying yourself immensely as you take in the surroundings. Every sound you hear is relaxing. It's almost like laughter. You can hear the little trills of laughter everywhere you turn. It's a happy place. You look ahead and you see that there's a little bit of a clearing, but you don't see a tree. But you know something's there. You continue to press forward. See almost like a curtain beckoning you. You reach forward, outstretching your hand, and there it is, a curtain of leaves, of flowers, that when you touch it, opens. This curtain are the boughs of this tree that you've been searching for. You take your hands and you separate the bough and you enter. It's glorious. The tree is almost glowing with a white light. You look around and that curtain, those boughs are completely surrounding the tree. And bright lights are shining in different spots of each branch. Know that something is supposed to be given to you here. It's like sacred ground almost. And so you step forward, you run your hand along the trunk of the tree. It's smooth to the touch. And you decide, I'm gonna sit. You have a seat and lean your back against this great tree. The air pulsating with energy and life and laughter and so much beauty. As you sit, I want you to think of something in your life that you are grateful for and that you are joyful for. As you think about that, listen to this thought. The joy we feel has little to do with the circumstances of our lives and everything to do with the focus of our lives. Joy, you can have joy in the midst of any circumstances, but where's your focus? And you're seated at the base of this tree to find some joy because you need it right now. Lights on the tree that are shining so bright that you need to take and pick and realize this is what I need to be grateful for. This is what I have to be joyful for. You know what it is. Because gratitude unlocks the fullness of life. It turns what we have into enough and more, right? So the uniqueness of this tree, of this particular beautiful place, is that in order to take from the tree, you have to leave something. Some kind of exchange needs to happen in order for you to take that joy, that gratitude. What is it that's weighing you down? What is it that makes you ungrateful in your life? Because really you don't need it. Whatever those thoughts are that make you feel heavy, alone, hopeless, helpless, worthless, any of those things that are really just awful things that we shouldn't think about, I want you to take that and leave it at the base of the tree. Exchange. Remember what you have to be grateful for, thankful for, joyful for. We have so much. Make that exchange happen, and maybe it's many exchanges. Take some time, really think deep and hard about what it is, because only you can make that choice. And every one of us is called to be grateful. It's not an option. We have to get through this life, not to mention this time in our history. So find it. Dig in, lay it down at the base of that tree. what you have to exchange in order to receive that ball of light from this beautiful tree. Go ahead and grab that light, that beautiful light or lights. Put them in your pocket. It's time to go. You feel full, energized, and grateful, of course. You turn around and you say your goodbye to the tree, and you walk again through the curtain, parting it. So magical. And now you've got potential and gratefulness and joy in your pockets with you. And please remember, of course, this tree is metaphorical, but it is there for you anytime. Anytime you need to take a refresher course on, man, I need to change my attitude. Go to the tree. Imagine it in your mind's eye. Take whatever is being heavy and holding you down, place it at the base of the tree, and grab onto something positive. Grab onto that gratefulness. It's not going to be a one-time thing. We have to continue to choose to be grateful, right? You're making your way out of that beautiful forest, refreshed, like I said, energized, ready to take on the world in the most relaxed way possible. We're gonna finish this time with one more breathing set. So with your hand on your belly, hand on the heart, once again, go ahead and breathe in, filling your diaphragm full, 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 raising that hand on the belly higher than the hand on the heart, in through the nose and out through the mouth. Three more breaths. This right here, what you're doing is almost like restarting your computer. Things start to not work anymore. It gets a little buggy, a little glitchy. This breathing is like that. It's a reset button. It's a restart button. So breathe in. into a seated position, whatever's best for you. I leave you with a final thought. It is not joy that makes us grateful. It is gratitude that makes us joyful. I'm gonna say it again. It is not joy that makes us grateful. It's gratitude that makes us joyful, right? Choosing that attitude of gratitude every time, despite how you're feeling, that is what produces joy. And we all could use a little bit more of that these days, right? I want to thank you so much for joining me tonight. I appreciate you. I appreciate you coming, and I hope this helped in any way, shape, or form. Pass it on. If you know someone who's super stressed right now and they need just a time of relaxation, please send this their way. Thank you so much. Love you all. I will see you tomorrow for LIIT, 8 a.m., live on Facebook. Mwah. Bye, guys.